40 minutes, get the same move with every club. I'm the only golfer with the feeling of greatness. I'm the only golfer living. I've got the master move and the feeling of greatness.
Yes, the feeling of greatness. This is the podcast with Todd Graves. I got my good friend Scott Renfrow and the master of single point 30 here in the studio today. We have a discussion we have to have, Scott, today about single point 30.
Okay.
Because this is third month, right?
Of the program. We are in our third month. We have now run just over 400 of our golfers through.
400 people through single point 30. So what we need to discuss today is, I think the discussion of single point 30 today will be, if people will listen to this podcast and listen to this information we're going to give them today, we'll take our advice of single point 30 and what the program is actually designed to do and how it's designed and what we've put together with that, could be the most transformational thing they can do for their golf game going forward. And I say that with some gravity because, I don't think we've ever designed at Graves Golf a better, more powerful program than Single Point 30 for learning, developing, and maintaining all those three things, your golf swing. So I wanted to bring you in the studio today, and just because you're the main designer of the program and we've worked diligently to develop this thing out to be the correct program for achieving just those things. You've seen the people that have gone through it. We had another show last night. You talk to these people every single week that are going through it. Explain to them exactly. Let's talk to people. What is Single Point 30? What is the program? Why is it different? What is the program? Let's just go there first.
Okay. So Single Point 30, it's very unique in the industry. It's unique to Graves Golf. Obviously it's something we've never really put together before in our history, but very unique in the industry, in that it completely, not even going to compare to what things are out there, because everybody knows what's out there. The 5-minute slice fix. Single Point 30, the program is designed the way we as humans learn any skill worth having, any skill that we want to be good at. I think in one of our webinars, we talked about, it's like learning how to dance or learning how to play the piano. And the program is designed that we learn things in the correct order and we focus on things in the correct order in order to build a physical skill, an athletic skill, and a movement of our body. So the program, in 30 days, we start out with our address and grip. It is our foundational instruction. That puts our bodies into position to be able to move correctly. And that's for a lot of our golfers. Like I said, we're over 400 golfers now. And, a lot of our golfers have gone through, have been with us for years. And the comments that we're getting back is like, they're blown away. I mean, guys that have spent tens of thousands of dollars with us are like, this $297 is the best I've ever spent because it's keeping me focused. So let me get back. What is the, what does a program do? So the first week we're walking people through how to build the foundation, how to position the body to be able to move correctly and then start moving the body correctly. And then for every week, then we build on that, we're building on that. So we address and grip, working on how to position the body to get the club to move correctly. And then, so we're building the positions of our golf swing.
Progressive training.
It's progressive training.
And this is where I think, this is where I think all golf instruction has gone wrong.
Absolutely. I couldn't agree.
Because in my experience now teaching for over 24 years with Graves Golf, thousands of golfers, watching people have success and some not have success. Well, I've seen it all. And the people that do have success will have worked themselves through, whether they did it by themselves, a progressive way of learning the swing. Because you're not going to, let's put it this way, you're not going to have a great golf swing, a great single point swing with a crappy address and grip position.
Nope.
There's no way to do it.
Well, you can't have a consistent golf swing.
No, you can't. Consistency, but I mean, everything goes together.
Right.
Just like speed. Speed goes with good technique, right? Mm-hmm. And so, you know, all these things have to work together. Consistency, speed, technique, all those things are part of progressing yourself with good mechanics. And I've said it, and I said it when we did the single plane 30, when we launched it. I said, you know, the beauty of it is this: when it comes to ball striking, it's not always about how great you hit it. It's about how good your bad shots are.
Yeah.
And that's what good golf swings do, is they're good when they're not good. And you hit good shots even when you make bad swings, because you can't really make a bad swing because you got to, you know. And so this is where this program is so powerful for me. But it's derived a lot from our 4D training.
From biomechanics training, yes.
Because this is where, you know, this was the evolution of, look, you know, we have a 4D system that we put people in, we can measure and quantify their movements. But if you don't have a 4D system on, how do you actually do that? Well, this type of program progresses you through everything I would teach you in a 4D system, monitoring you in the correct order, progressing you through address and grip, then into the backswing, then downswing, through swing, and learning the positions of the swing before you get into the sequencing of the swing. Because if you can't hit the positions of the golf swing, just follow me on this, and this is where the powerful training gets really highlighted. If you can't hit the positions, how can you expect to then sequence those positions, hit those positions in full speed?
Right.
Right. So if you haven't figured out how to make a good on plane backswing in slow motion position training, you're not going to do it. But when we add speed to it,
nope.
And that's really what's all about. So what you do is, if you're going to progressively train, you learn those positions where does the body need to go? How does it feel? You repetitions. Repetitions is a big part of single plane 30.
Huge, huge part of it.
And then, you know, then when you finally realize, and we've had, you know, give us some examples of some of the things that people are saying about single plane 30, because you've talked to a lot of the guys that are going through it.
Well, I'll go to, we've got a student from New Mexico. He's actually one of our level 4 elite customers. Very, very invested in his own improvement. Been with us for 4 years. And has done multiple golf schools, but I mean, he's completely bought in, 100% burned the boats. And he goes through this program last month. And at the end of the program, his comment was, and I think I mentioned it a little bit earlier, he said, this is the best training that I've ever done in the single plane swing. Because, and you know, he said, because it keeps me focused on what I should be doing every single day.
Yeah.
Every single day, I know exactly what I should be doing.
Yep.
And then, you know, it gives me a very clear formula to follow, you know, the clarity of the program from the golfer's perspective. And this is the common thread that I hear when talking to those who've gone through the program is the clarity of it. This is, you know, I've got to do this. I've got, you know, today's this. This week I'm focusing on this. Next week, okay, now I'm focusing on this. So the clarity of it, there's no guesswork, you know. And as a golfer who's worked through this stuff myself personally, that clarity, that direction, is key.
Yeah.
Because you know, so much of what most of us go through in learning golf is we basically spend all of our time guessing.
Yeah.
I had a Zoom call with my with the current group yesterday afternoon late, and one customer's like, he said, you know, he said, I thought I had a pretty good address until I did this.
Yeah.
You know, so again, they don't, you know, it just keeps you focused on the important things.
It's so fundamental.
It is. It's so fundamental. You know, you brought it. You mentioned when we started the podcast, you said this was the program was great for learning, developing, and then maintaining. And I think those three things.
Yeah.
You know, for learning the swing, short of coming to a golf school, short of hiring an instructor to walk you through this, it's by far the easiest way to learn.
Well, think about something. So like, there's guys that right now that I teach that I've been teaching for 10, 15 years.
Right.
What do I teach them?
The single plane, the stuff that
I teach them, the same thing I taught them day year one.
Correct.
It's just a reinforcement of what they, you know, it's a reinforcement of the fundamental stuff where they're at. But I there's no way I could teach them and not look at their address and grip.
Nope.
Check their positions out. And then, so you get this order of, we talk about model, order, measure. You get this, you know, you're matching the model. Where do you need to be focusing your attention? You know, for example, I just left California where I was teaching out there. And one of the guys I teach out there always tends to get his lead hand too weak and then the face gets open. And so it's an address and grip issue. And then it kind of goes into an open face and then he starts hooking the ball. And so here you go. Like, you don't just say, okay, well, let's try to not hook the golf ball. You fix the grip at address. You fix the hand position, which then adjusts his hand position and his address position. And then he starts getting the face. Then he hooks it worse at first, which is interesting. Then he learns to get the impact a little better and then he stops hooking it. It's dead straight. So it's just this progression that people have to understand. What I always tell people about single point 30, it's, here's what it's not. It's easier to kind of explain what it's not.
Right.
It's not a quick fix program.
No.
Right. This is a building, developing, maintaining program. I want people that have been through single point 30 to keep going through it.
It's an interesting thing because the folks who have gone through it, the people who have completed the program, are now asking me, hey, can you reset it for me so I can do it again?
Yeah.
So because they are now seeing the value of this is it. This is how we build. This is how we develop. And this is how we maintain.
Yeah.
And constantly stay on a trajectory towards better ball, you know, more consistent, the consistent ball striking and the consistency we all want.
Yeah.
This is how we stay on that trajectory.
What's interesting though, if I look at my progression as a guy building my golf swing, you know, over the years, and it happened very much like this progression because I had, you know, I really didn't have an instructor other than Mo. And, you know, I've always said it, Mo wasn't sitting here teaching me the golf swing. I was learning from Mo. Mm-hmm. He wasn't teaching me the golf swing, that if you understand the difference of that. Right. And so I'm learning from Mo and I'm picking up on things and then I'm experimenting. Okay. I see his left hand here. I see his body tilted here. I see his position here, you know, and I'm kind of picking up on these things, but it's really interesting as I started developing and I started seeing my swing progress and get better is I could start, and we've heard this in the program, I could do things in my ball striking that I could never do before. We've heard that from numerous single plane 30 participants saying, now I can do things I couldn't do before. That's because you're hitting positions that you've never hit before, which means the club is doing things it's never done before, which means you're impacting the ball differently than you've impacted before. So it progresses through that. And until you've been through it, until you've actually done it, you don't know how powerful it really is.
Right. No, it's because you're guessing.
Yes.
You're doing what 99% of golfers out there do is just guess at it. You know, oh, I'm slicing the golf ball, so let me go find a fix for the slice. Well, the fix for the slice is just good mechanics. And that's what this program is helping us build. And it's why it's not a one-time thing. And there's really no, oh, it's just for this golfer. It's just for this golfer that's getting started. Really, it's not. It's for any single plane golfer, anybody wanting to be great with a single plane.
Like you mentioned a minute ago, our longtime students who have been with us for years are going through it.
Yeah.
And they're having a lot of success with it. And part of so just so you know, when we set the program up, we released the first month, we released a week at a time.
Yes, we did.
I remember that. And so what happens is when you release the week training, everybody looks at the whole week training.
And does the last day. Yes.
So we learned really quickly. And it was requested because we did a Zoom call. We do Zoom calls with you guys when you're in single point 30. Yeah. And we did a Zoom call. And one of the students says, hey, we only release the day we're training. That way we don't get ahead of ourselves. So that's when we stopped doing that. And then the students, now they love that. They're like, this is the most powerful thing. And then they complain about it too. It's so funny.
Well, it's interesting. I was I did the Zoom yesterday with the current group that's going through the program and they're in the middle of week three. And so, you know, they're 20 days through it. They've got about 10 days left in their first 30 day, you know, in this to get through the program. And I was giving them a hard time. I was cause like, you guys were all complaining in week one. They're like, oh, why do we got to do this same thing? There's nothing new. There's nothing new today. You know, this is all, it's a pattern now. In week one, we're working on address position, address grip, and getting the first movement of this, of the body, getting the club to move. And they're like, we did this yesterday.
Yeah.
We did this yesterday. And then now 20 days into it, they're like, I get it now. I get it now.
Yeah.
I get
it. If because, they make it that far. Yeah.
Right. Because it is the repetition.
Yeah.
It's the repetition that builds the, I mean, we could go pretty deep here in the, how we learn, but it is the repetitions that build the movement. It's not the knowledge that builds the movement.
So, you know, you said this about Chris here in our office, that success is boring.
Success is very boring.
Okay.
Yeah.
Let's just go to that scenario because anybody who's been successful at building a swing has done the same thing over and over again.
Yes, absolutely.
Okay. It's boring as hell. It's just reps with the same thing over again. It's not like you're, you know, reinventing everything every day and having this hugely exciting experience. Look, I've been through this.
Mm-hmm.
And like the other day I was in California and I was working in the sim bay and I had, I have all the technology in there. Every bit of technology is in there and I don't have it on. I didn't turn any of it on. I'm just pulling a ball. I got something I'm working on. Wham, hit a ball.
Mm-hmm.
I pull a ball. Wham, hit another one, pull a ball. And I'm doing this for like 30 minutes. And one of the guys walks over and goes, you're not even gonna turn this thing on. I'm like, why? I don't give a shit. I'm just here to get reps on what I'm feeling in my backswing right now. I want reps. I want to get this away. Because to be honest with you, one would feel a little different than another. And I couldn't focus on the feeling. Like I couldn't focus on the feeling if I kept worrying about the sim ball flying out there in the range, right?
Right.
And I because that's super distracting. Like once I turn that thing on, man, I'm watching the thing fly. And so I'm focused on that feeling. And I'm, okay, the club went, that felt, man. And there was times where I'd hit the position like, man, that was it. Grab a ball real quick, try to hit that same position. It was just doing reps and reps and reps on one freaking thing in my backswing. Well, that's why I'm good. Because I can do the most boring, mundane thing and focus on one movement over and over and over and over again to get it. And look, if you're watching the video and you're watching me swing, you're like, they all look the same. They did. They all look exactly the same in the video.
Right.
They didn't all feel the same. They didn't all feel the same. I was getting little different feelings and I was getting that. And I was just triggering. I was focusing my attention on the little feelings I was getting and the reps of that just over. And once I got that feeling, it was like, just let me get like 1,000 reps of that feeling, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And gosh, that takes so much discipline. And so what we're doing with single point 30 is we're disciplining people.
Yeah. It's like the adult, you know, it's like the, when you were a child, you're doing this because that's what why am I doing this? Because I said so. That's kind of the, yeah. And that's the initial yeah. feeling when people start the program. Well, why are we doing the same thing over? Because I said so.
And that's,
but as they get in the program, like, okay, I get it now. I get it.
Do you think that's our biggest problem is human adults?
Oh, I think all of us human adults are, that's our problem as a species, but that's a different conversation.
No, but I mean, it's worthy. It's what this podcast is about. Right. It's like, it's really about, God, are we just undisciplined in a way that, because we want this quick fix or we want these instant results and we want this instantaneous success. And especially when it comes to golf, because it's a fun thing we like to do. And we want to just watch the YouTube, watch a video and go get success. And I tell people, like every webinar I've done on Single Point 30 has been, my YouTube channel is the worst place for you to learn the golf swing.
Absolutely, you know? The worst place. If you want to be entertained, it's awesome.
Yeah, it's fine. But
and I am on a similar vein with the folks I talk to now. I was like, listen, you can consume all the information you want. You can go watch all the videos you want. You can read all the books you want. You can read all the articles, listen to all the podcasts, all this stuff. The information's great. But without application, it's useless.
But you know what? It's a good point because you know who I admire the most in this world?
Mm.
People who are disciplined.
Yeah.
So why don't I learn from them? Right? Because if you look at anybody that's successful, whether it's business or finance or fitness or golf or any sport, doesn't matter which one, pick anything. Playing a musician, they were disciplined enough to get into the room and not turn the sim bay on and just do reps and reps and reps and reps and reps until they couldn't. That's all they knew. Well, God dang it. I think that's what people need is discipline. As we age, we get more impatient. We expect, you know, things are easier for us and maybe we get success and we have money and I can just buy whatever I need. And
mm-hmm.
and so, but you can't buy a golf swing. You have to discipline yourself into a golf swing or anything fitness. You have to discipline yourself into fitness. It's the discipline. It's the getting up early. It's the working out. It's the doing the reps. It's the consistency of eating, all the things that we have to do. I'm guilty of this shit.
All of us are. Yeah. I mean, it's a society we live in. I mean, it's just the, you know, we're fast. It's a fast paced world.
Yeah.
But the, you know, I think you really have to look at, you know, how to, the single, looking at single plane 30, why are people loving it so much? Because it does keep them disciplined.
Mm-hmm.
It keeps them on task every single day. And it keeps them on task doing the right things.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a conversation I was having with a group last week was, you know, on this journey to build a good golf swing as a, you know, to be consistent, to go enjoy playing the game more. I mean, let's look at the big picture of what folks come to us for. Building a good golf swing is not a destination. I mean, you just have to look at Mo. You know, Mo was in his early 70s. I mean, hell, he was hitting balls up to a few weeks before he passed. And people, why are you still hitting golf balls? He said, just make it stronger.
Mm-hmm.
It's a pursuit of perfection. It's not a destination of perfection. And so the conversation that I have with people is, listen, getting better at golf, hitting the ball better, stopping a slice, not the body not hurting, things like that, is a pursuit. And as you continue, like in a program like Single Plane 30, where you're just building better movement of your body, and that's resulting in a better club movement, which is resulting in a better impact position. Those results take care of themselves, and they just continually get a little better. But even you, I've known you for 20 years, and you know, people look at your golf swing and they're like, wow, that's awesome. And they watch your ball fly. You're like, that's awesome. And I look at it as like, I know you well enough. Like, he's not happy with that because it's the pursuit. It's not the, hey, I've got it. Well, you know,
two questions for you. So first question is, does discipline feel good? When you're disciplined at something, does it feel good to be disciplined about something? How is that reflective of why you would be disciplined? Because being undisciplined doesn't feel good.
No.
So to me, I want you to answer that, just that open-ended question. Does discipline feel good?
My answer would be yes. When that discipline is moving us towards our, in golf, if I'm going to be disciplined and go through a single plane 30 program, if I'm going to give 30 days to this and I'm going to do the work, you know, so my natural expectation is at the end of that 30 days, I'm going to be closer. I'm going to see results that, that get me closer to my goal, to what it is I want. And that's what we're seeing. That's what we're seeing is, you know, when these guys come out of single plane 30, they just follow it. It's tough. You know, it's not tough to follow it, but,
it takes discipline.
It takes discipline.
And that's why you said it's tough because discipline is tough for some people because it's mundane. It can be mundane and boring, but it's not boring because you're actually doing something. So to me, it's like me hitting balls in that sim the other day, just repeating the same feeling. It wasn't boring to keep repeating the same feeling over and over again because I was in pursuit of that feeling, right? And I would find it, you know, one of every three or four swings, and then I would get it twice in a row. Then it was like, you know, mm-hmm. That was it. That was actually really, really enjoyable. It's almost addictive in a way because, I mean, I'm just looking at my own like reaction to it. It's almost like that was it, you know, and then it was exciting. And it's funny because it's so different than the guy I'm teaching because he's over there going, why don't you turn the machine on and watch where it's going? And I'm like, because I don't really care where it's going. I care what I feel right now. I care. I told him, I go, this is why I've been successful because I can focus so heavily on one particular thing for a long period of time. And my brain isn't really wired for that, by the way. I'm a space cadet, right? I mean, I'm mm-hmm. everywhere. But when it came to the golf swing, I could do that with the golf swing. Because I was in pursuit, like you said, of that perfection of that movement. And when I found it, I wanted to keep it. And I think that is a absolute learned skill.
It is. It is. You know, it's something I've heard you say it multiple times. It's like, and in our, you know, in our history together of teaching, it's when you get the feeling, when you get it right, that's when you shut out the world and focus. You don't, it's not, oh, I felt it once, I've got it. No, when I get the feeling and I know it's right and I've gotten feedback, I've got more than one way to tell me that I'm doing this thing correctly, whatever this is. When I get that, that's when you shut the world out.
Okay.
And you focus.
I got another question for you. Headphones. Like one of the arguments I have with the kids when I'm,
what does headphones have to do anything?
No, listen.
Okay.
So I'm teaching these kids and they got the ear pods in.
Oh yeah.
And I'm like, how can you do that? They go, oh, I'm listening to music when I practice. I'm like, how can you do that? I go, because I can see if you're just going through the motions, right? Just hitting balls. Okay. Maybe. Cause I maybe can do that. Sometimes I'll turn my cart music on, hit balls. But when I'm actually in the space of, that's what I'm talking about, where you're hitting a position or trying to feel that new movement or get a sense of that new movement, it's auditory, it's mental, you have a voice in your head that's discussing it, you're totally engrossed in that feeling, like every sense, you know, how you feel in your hands, every sense is triggering on what you're doing. To be distracted by something in my ear, I can't do it.
Well, it's a societal issue too, because I know what you're saying. It's like, how can your brain focus on two things at once?
Yeah.
And so you've got music playing in your ear, but you're trying to make it to focus on, you know, you're being distracted by what you may consider white noise. You know, oh, I just got my ear pods in, I'm just listening to some music while I hit balls or while I putt or whatever, you know. But you're distracting the brain, and the brain, distracted brain can't focus.
I think that's a good point, because I think you can distract the brain if you're not trying to focus.
Yeah.
That's fine. I mean,
yeah, if you're not trying to
focus.
Yeah.
But if you're focusing on something, then you're just getting in the way of your distraction. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's interesting because here's the thing I run into a lot, and you have too as well, coaching is, and maybe this is a pet peeve and even a frustration of mine. A student will hit a bad shot and he'll say, what did I do? And I want to say to him, here's what my brain goes to. I don't always say it this way, but I can say everything on these podcasts. My brain always goes to, it doesn't effing matter what caused that ball to hook or whatever. It doesn't effing matter. Does it match the model? And if it doesn't, fix it. Work towards the model. Work towards the correct movement. Work towards the correct positions. Work towards the correct address and grip. It doesn't matter what that effing ball did. It doesn't matter the result you just got. Something created that result. Find out what it was, right? Find out what it was. Look at the model. Look at yourself. Oh, it's a closed club face. Why is it closed? Right? And it's not a fixing process. In that whole process, it's not fix the club face. It's just work towards correct, work towards correct, work towards correct. And so I'm always like, yeah, something was wrong. Yeah, the ball didn't go where you wanted it to go. Okay, what was it? It's a cause and effect thing. In the proper order, address and grip, positions of the backswing, you know. And so I'm always like, damn it. We get so caught up in, oh, it went left or went right or I didn't hit it good. Why? Well, just match the model. It's the same solution every single time. Keep matching the model. And so I think that's really where single plane 30 evolved from, is like, look, it's just, this is going to put you into the model. It's going to keep you in the model. It's going to give you reps in the model. It's going to keep you doing it the proper order. It's not letting you get ahead of yourself. It's just reps, correct reps, correct reps, correct reps. And you can't do it enough. I wish guys would do it every single month. Just keep redoing it.
Well, the other thing about the single plane 30 that listeners probably are not aware is it's that the program is indoors.
Yeah.
You don't hit golf balls while you're doing this.
Right.
What do you do? You know, so the you know, for those listening, well, what, okay, this sounds interesting. What am I actually doing? You're moving your body. And any place you have room to move your body with a golf club or a training aid in your hand is a place you can do single plane 30 work. So this is not I'm going to take this out the range and grind this out. Nope. You can do this at home. You can do this in the evenings. You can do this in the morning as part of your routine. It takes 15 to 20 minutes to do the work.
I wrote a deal. So I was writing a, I know it was a blog post, or I'm working on a second book I'm working on forever, but I was writing this section of, I think it was my book. And here's another question for you. I don't know if it's a question or more of just a comment to have you hear your comment on it. How do you train the brain? Like, so I'm going to train, the Dan Coyle thing of building the myelination and how you build a new program. How does that occur?
Repetition.
Okay. But go deeper, go deeper than repetition, because is it body movement that's neurologically training the brain? Or how about this? Or are you telling your body to do something? And then you do it, and that tells your brain. Like, it's such an interesting connection you have to have with your body.
Yeah. So that actually is a very good question, because when you're trying something that is different than what you're accustomed to, the brain's first reaction is stop, or this is weird, or this is not correct.
Doesn't feel right. Can't
be right. So your brain tells your the brain is saying to you, this can't be right. This doesn't feel good. I mean, how many times in a golf school, you put somebody in a position like, oh my God, if I had a dollar for every time I've heard that feels weird, we'd do the podcast on our yacht.
Yeah.
Because that's our brain. Golfers, and this is not, I mean, obviously in the context of golf, but every golfer out there listening to this has built a habitual swing.
Yeah.
It's a habit.
It's in their brain.
It's wired.
So you got to rewire it.
And so when you're trying to build something better, something that you have, you know, made a logical decision, this is better. This is going to help me. This is what I want. This is the direction I want to go. So you make that logical decision. You look at single plane swing. You're like, yep, that's the answer I've been looking
for. Anyways, make a decision to change. Okay, commit to it. Burn the boats.
So now, you burn the boats. There we go. So now the change part of it. When your brain says, when you put your body into a position and the brain says that weird, then you have to tell the, you just override. Have to keep doing
you
it.
You have to override.
You have to keep doing it.
That's interesting.
We tell golfers, embrace the weird.
Yeah.
We tell our students, embrace the weird, because here's what happens. Okay. That feels terrible. How many, I'll never be able to hit a golf ball from that position. You know, you get this self-talk going, oh my God, that feels like shit. I'm not going to get to the impact from there. The discipline is to keep doing it.
Yeah.
But why do you keep doing it? Because it matches the model.
Yeah. See, that's it. It's the override process that it's interesting that this conversation, because what you just referred to was, it feels weird. I've got to override myself because I don't want to feel weird. So, okay, override. I'm going to override this and just.
Well, let's talk about the override.
Mm-hmm.
So what is the override look like in practice? And that, I think that's part of the why single plane 30 is very popular, and guys want me to, and people want to keep doing it. And it's what we're saying as well. Is because you know, you can see I'm in the correct position. This is where I want to be. You do the repetitions until the brain doesn't tell you that feels weird anymore. Well, that is the point. And I don't have the science to back this up, just the experience. I'm going to embrace the weird until it doesn't feel weird.
Yeah.
Because when it doesn't feel weird, my brain has now said, okay, I'm good with this. So but, now my brain is now able to tell my body, this is what we did.
But have you reinforced the override with the reinforcement? Like, that matches the model.
Yeah.
Like, so to me, it looks weird. It feels weird. It can't be right. Oh, but it matches the model.
But it matches the model.
There's a reinforcement there. I think it's very important that it gets reinforced. Like, okay, it doesn't make sense to me right now, but that's where it must be done from. Right.
Correct.
Because that's what I've gone through.
I was going to say, you've gone through the same thing.
Oh. I probably go through it all the time. I still go through it when I make a little change. Every time I make a change, there's not one change I've ever made that is like, that feels weird, but it's like, wow.
But the answer is, does it get me closer to doing the matching the model?
Matching the model. It does it make the club move correctly. You know, that's it's all those things. And so the override has to be reinforced.
The override
needs to be reinforced.
It needs to be reinforced through repetition.
Right.
And that is the discipline.
Yeah, exactly.
And that's the discipline. That's why single plane 30, you know, the guys, I love our customers, but I've now had three groups go through it, 400 people. And in the first, I don't mind telling people, in the first week, you're going to do a dress grip and position one for six straight days.
Which is nothing, but
it's nothing for you and me. But these guys are like, I did this shit yesterday. And I'm like, do you got it? Does it feel good? No, keep doing it. Keep doing it. Because, yeah. And the reason we're forcing that discipline is the override.
Yeah.
Is the override. Is doing the repetition until the override, to help the override happen.
Yeah.
Because it's, if you ask me to set up in a two-plane golf swing, can't do it. If that feels weird to me now.
Oh, I can do it. I don't know what it is anymore, but I can try. Yeah.
Right. So that is the single plane 30. Why is it such a good program? Why is it something every golfer listening to this should be doing? Just speaking from a golfer's perspective, because this is the process we all have to go through to get what we want.
Yeah.
This is the shortcut that we all think we're looking for. You know, the shortcut is not a 10-minute YouTube video or a quick tip or a train, you know, or this one miracle training aid. I mean, yes, we've got training aids, but our training aids are built to fit into the system. The shortcut is to match the model, work in the right order, and measure.
And what's interesting about this process is,
and repeat.
Well, it's a reprogramming process because you override the old program.
Override, yep.
And then you put in a new program and then you reinforce the new program with repetition. It's a reprogramming process. That's why in its design, it's 30 days because the way we formulated this program was like somebody came to me and said, Todd, if you had to put together a perfect training program, how many days would it be? And I was like, well, it has to be more than a week. 2 weeks isn't enough.
Mm-hmm.
3 weeks, maybe. At least 30 days, like 30 days of this. But what we're seeing is 30 days plus another 30, which is what I'm seeing is guys go through and they love it. They transform in 30 days. They want to do it again to make sure they got it.
Yeah.
So I'm seeing a 60 day program here, but 30 days get you there. And, so we got to wrap up, but anybody who's listening to this program right now wants to join Single Plane 30. How do they get involved in Single Plane 30? If they wanted to get in the program for next month, because by the way, we start this at the beginning of every month.
So the flow we've gotten into is the program starts on the first Monday for the first Monday of every month. It's just how it's just easy, you know, from administration to flow.
Let me tell you about that though. Because everybody is going through the program at the same pace and same time, you and I as coaches and the coaches are able to know where everybody's at as they're going through it, which helps the process tremendously because you're doing Zoom calls with them every Monday.
I'm doing once a week, once every 10 days with this group.
But you're helping them. You're coaching them through the program.
Right.
And for example, one person's not in week three and one person's week one. You're like, okay, you're ahead of that guy. Everybody's in the same place.
Mm-hmm.
So it really flows well with the quality of our ability to help people through and progress in the right pace and order. Whereas one guy doesn't get ahead of himself. Like if you open the whole program up and one guy's in week three and one guy's in week one, he's like, oh, I've already been through that. No, you didn't go through it enough. You didn't repeat it enough. You didn't give yourself time to learn. By the way, I'll throw a little spin on this before we wrap. You know what one of the most important parts of learning is? Rest and sleep.
Mm-hmm.
And so what people tend to do a lot of times, and I've seen this and there's science behind this, is they will train too much in a period of time and they never get any of it because they didn't, because here's the problem.
Needs a break.
Your brain needs, but it needs a break, but sleep is how you process the changes.
Mm-hmm.
And then the next day, okay, so your brain's being changed. Let's just put that out there. If I override your old program and I give you a new program, I just changed your brain.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what it is, right? Well, I just changed your brain. New cells, new
neural pathways.
Neural pathways. Okay, great. Well, rest is the way those things wire themselves up. Mm-hmm. And people don't understand that rest is like the most important part of training. Well, okay, rest and then more training, more direct, perfect, focused training. Then rest And so those days that you're, that guys are doing the same thing, the rest periods are so wrapped into that.
Yeah.
If they got ahead of themselves, they never got enough rest and learn. So that's what I'm saying, is that the program has a great design and it's correctly designed. It starts off pretty, you know, what you said, pretty disciplined. Mm-hmm. And then when people start moving more, they get more happy, but,
right, yeah.
but it's funny because it's such an important process for people, and there's science behind it. There's neural science behind it. It's just the way it is. I'm sorry that the human brain is designed like it is. Like I apologize for God's design of the brain, but that's just the way it is.
It's the way we're built.
It's the way we're built.
Unfortunately, we're not in the Matrix. You can't just plug the thing in and upload jujitsu or single plane golf swing. I mean,
yeah, you know, if you want to get in next month, look, so here's the way this works. If you want to get in next month, single plane 30, you need to contact Scott, Scott R at gravesgolf.com.
Scott R at gravesgolf.com. There's also, you go to gravesgolf.com/SP/singleplane30.
Okay. I'm going to have him just email you.
Yeah. And it's probably easier to email for right now.
And right. And we'll probably put a link on this.
Put a link on the podcast. It's a little shorter.
But get in. If you miss the month, you got to wait a month, right?
Yeah,
so you got to get in the next month. So coming up, we got one coming up.
A week from Monday.
We got one coming up. Right. So 1 week from now. So if people listen to this, I mean, I don't know when this podcast is going to get published, but when people listen to this, they need to get in the program so they don't miss the month.
Because it's 3 days. I mean, you think about it. If you're looking to transform, to get more consistent, to put yourself on the road to that, then if you don't get into the one that starts on April the 1st, you're going to have to wait until May the 6th. You're 60, you're almost, you know, you're, it's on
40 something days,
40 something days away.
Yeah.
And so, you know, it's like, I mean, I don't know. I'm older now. 40 days is a long time.
Oh, well, it's part of the year, right? So right. I want to get training as much as I can. So yes, thank you, Scott, for joining me today on Three Guys Podcast. Great information. Single Point 30. Great job on the program. It will be our next 10-year or more program for Graves Golf.
Yeah.
We're going to try to put 100,000 people through Single Plane 30 in the next few years. So Thanks for such a great job. And great thing about it is just going to get better and better.
Better and better. Yep. Thank you, Todd.